Hello everyone and welcome to our next video lecture on PPS. Now in today's video lecture, we are going to see concept of delegation and containership in Python. Now let us start with example directly, and while writing that program, I will explain you what delegation and what containership is. Okay. Now let us consider a class, say for example, faculty. Okay. Now in that faculty class, I am going to have a constructor. So let us have that constructor which has the first parameter as self, and next one is, I am going to use this faculty class for calculating total number of marks achieved by student. So I am going to have three variables, say for example marks acquired by student in SEM, then in practical, and then in end SEM examination. Okay, now let us have those attributes in this constructor. So self dot, I will have in SEM, then in SEM, then similarly I will have self dot practical mark, then we will have track, and then similarly I will write for the third attribute, that is NSEM mark equal to NSEM. Okay, so these are the attributes that I have defined in faculty class using a constructor in it. Now let us write one more function that calculates the marks of the student. Okay, so here what I will do is, I will use a return statement which will calculate self dot say for example in same plus self dot track marks plus self dot NSEM mark. Okay, so in faculty class I have taken one constructor in which I have taken three parameters, that is NSEM for NSEM mark, track parameter for practical marks, NSEM parameter for NSEM mark. Okay, then I have taken one more function called as marks, which will calculate total number of marks achieved by student. Okay, now let us go for the second class, and that class is of student class. Okay, now this student class will also have one constructor. Okay, init constructor. The first parameter should be self, then we will have yes name, that is name of the student, and let us consider year of the student. Now apart from these two parameters, I will include three more parameters, that are in same marks, practical marks, and in same marks. So I will include this also. So I will simply copy and paste over it over here. Okay. Right. So I have this constructor in student class. So let us have those attributes self dot yes name, which is equal to yes name. Then I will have self dot year, which is equal to year. Okay. Now remember one thing. Here we are going to see delegation. Okay, and containership with respect to composition. Now what is composition basically? Because in order to implement delegation, you either perform composition or you do inheritance. Now remember one thing, you cannot perform inheritance over here, because there is no easier relationship between student and faculty, because in order to perform inheritance, you should have is a relationship. You should have is a relationship in order to perform inheritance. Okay, but there is no is a relation between faculty and student. Means faculty is not a student and student is not a faculty. Okay, now here which relationship is there? There is a has a relationship. Which relationship? Has a relationship. So when is a relationship is not there between two classes, then you cannot perform inheritance. Then we should go for composition. We should go for composition. Okay. Now, what is composition basically in Python? Composition means we are delegating responsibility of one class to another class, from one class to another class. Okay. Now, delegation can be done by creating object of one class into another class. Now, here, remember one thing, that student has marks. Okay, but marks are not supposed to be calculated by students. They are supposed to be calculated by faculty. Okay, are you understanding this? Okay, so what we are going to do is, we are going to delegate calculation of marks from student class to faculty class. We are going to delegate which responsibility? Calculation of marks to which class? Faculty class. Okay. Now, how you are going to do that? You are going to create object of faculty class in student class. So, let us have one more variable over here, that is obj underscore faculty. Faculty. So, this is the syntax for creating object. Remember that in Python, this is the syntax for creating object of the class. So, obj underscore faculty is the name of the object, whereas faculty is the class. So, what I am doing basically, I am delegating the responsibility of calculating marks to which class? Faculty class. From which class? Student class. Okay. Now here, I need to pass three parameters. Which are those three parameters? Insame, prac and insame. So, pass those three parameters when you are creating object of class faculty. Okay. So, delegation can be done by creating object of faculty class in student class. So, normally we create object outside the class, right? But here, what I want to do is, I want to delegate responsibility of calculating marks from student class to faculty class. So, I am creating object of faculty class in which class? Student class. That is what delegation means. Okay. Now, once you have created object of faculty class in student class, now, next part, is printing the total marks. So let us have another function. Sorry. Okay. Which will display the total marks of the student. So let us have T marks, which is total marks. Okay. Then we'll have self. And what we are going to do is, we are going to print self dot obj underscore faculty, that is the name of the object of each class, faculty class, dot which function in faculty class is calculating total marks, that is marks function. Okay, so I'll call that over here. Okay, that's it. Okay, so this is what the these two classes represent. Okay. Now one more thing. Now remember that here the student class is called as container, while faculty class is contained. Student class is container, which contains which class? Faculty class. So student class will become container, whereas faculty class is contained. Okay, so your student class is container and faculty class is contained. Why? Because student class contains object of faculty class, means I am creating object of faculty class within student class. Okay, so this is the concept of containership in Python. This is the concept of containership in Python. Now let us create object of class student. Okay, say for example, S is the object of class student. So student, and how many parameters we are going to pass? Now look, here I have got a constructor. So when there is constructor in your class, values should be passed to these attributes of constructor when you are creating object of that class. So here I am going to pass name of the student, say for example ABC. Then I am going to pass year of the student, that is first year, and then I am going to pass marks. In same marks, say for example out of 30, 20 marks, then practical marks are out of 25, so let us consider 20 marks for practicals also out of 25. Then in same mark is 70, out of 70, so I will consider 50 marks. Okay, and let us call t marks function of student class by using object s. Okay, now let us execute this. Okay, so what it should display? It should display total number of marks obtained by a student. Okay, so let us execute this program. Yes, we got 90 as output over here. Okay, so remember 90 we got because in ancient student have 50 marks, in practical 20 marks, and in same we have got that student has got 20 marks. So total where I am performing addition over here in this faculty. Okay, so remember we have got two classes, faculty class and student class. Faculty class is used for calculating total marks achieved by a student. Okay, student class is acting as a container because it contains faculty, object of faculty class. Okay, then we are delegating responsibility of marks calculation to which class? Faculty class. Okay, so this is what concept of delegation and containership is in Python programming language. I hope you got this concept of delegation and containership. Okay, if you have any doubt with respect to containership and delegation, you can tell me. Thank you so much.